Sony just can't catch a break. Yes, last month it came out in a story about former Sony executive turned outside producer with a deal at Sony, Doug Belgrad. There was a story about his upcoming slate of films. And one of those movies was a Mulan adaptation, which was going to be made, and maybe still will be, although I don't know, considering this new announcement, but would be made in partnership with the Chinese, or players in the Chinese film industry. But I guess, and everybody picked up on that, because everybody's been really jonesing for a live-action Mulan ever since this whole live-action fairy tale craze began. And I guess Disney, I guess it really lit a fire under Disney, and they were like, we can't get beat to the punch on this. Look what happened with Snow White. Now, I don't think anybody was really jonesing for a live-action Snow White movie from Disney, but still, they want to maintain their monopoly. And darn it, these fairy tales are in the public domain. So they have announced today, this is amazing, hot on the heels of their live-action Lion King announcement last week, that they are not only making a live-action Mulan, and this was in development before, so that's not a huge surprise, but today they put a ring on it with a release date, and that is November 2nd, 2018. And they did have that date already reserved for a live-action fairy tale previously. So I guess those reservations that the studios make, at least with Disney, there's some truth to them, right? Now, also, in terms of positioning, this is already a very competitive month, November 2018. So Mulan will kick it off, but then the week after, Universal's Illumination Entertainment will release their animated The Grinch. And then the week after that, Warner Brothers, Disney and Warner Brothers. So, you know, like it's almost taking on mythological proportions, the competition between the two studios. But their Fantastic Beasts sequel will be hitting theaters. So what a month! I have to ask you right away, what's your top priority to see that month? I think those all look good. I guess that really sucks for October. Everyone will just save their money. Now, also, Disney announced this film will be in 3D. For those of you who are Muppet 3D fans from Hollywood Studios. But it'll be in 3D, and I'm very excited about that because I've always felt that while I really love the animated movie Mulan from Disney, I feel like the concept art they did for that film to prepare for it and the poster for the film, like the serious poster, they never really realized that potential. They never lived up to that promise. So to make this really, you know, more sumptuous, a little bit, just to take everything up a notch like they have been doing with all their live action films, I think is very exciting indeed. Now here's the big question that I'm sure many of you are waiting for. Who will play Mulan, right? Well, they're taking a page from Cinderella's book and they're gonna have a glass slipper, or is that golden slipper, or even better, golden sword, as they search globally for a Chinese actress to play Mulan. Wow! So if you're an actress who's Chinese, you have to have Chinese ancestry because it's super political over there. So it has to be a Chinese actress. It doesn't say where you have to be from, but you have to have Chinese heritage. Get that headshot ready to send over to Disney. Now, I don't know if it's an open casting call. They didn't specify that. Open means you don't have to have representation. Literally anyone can audition. So we'll see if they go that route. But at least if you have an agent, you know, it's like Aui'i Cravajo, who's the voice of Moana. She is a newcomer that Disney found to make sure that film is authentic and its ethnicity of the talent. Yet she did have an agent. And it gets even better. Rick Jaffa and Amanda Silver have been announced as the screenwriters, or at least the script doctors on the film, handling the spec script, rewriting it for Disney. I love this writing team. They're one of my favorite writing teams of all time. I fell in love with them with The Relic, which where the science of that film was really impressive. Like, you're like, wow, you really thought this through. And they took that science know-how to write fantastic new Planet of the Apes movies. One, a little better than two, but they did work on Jurassic World, which is very, I think turned out obviously very well, and on the upcoming Avatar movie. So James Cameron vouches for them, which is pretty exciting. But as you can see with their track record there, they're all about science. So I'm curious to see if they're going to take that science know-how and really thread the history through this film, because Disney says they want it to be a mix of the ancient Chinese legend and the film that they made. Does that mean Mushu is in or out, right? I don't know. If they can do like a CGI Mushu and make him like really cool and like slithery, right? That could be amazing. I hope they bring Eddie Murphy back to do the voice. He could totally do it. I don't know if he'd still be interested, but come on. That could, I think they could sell a lot of toys. But anyway, they don't have a director set yet. I think they might want to hire a Chinese director. I don't know. We'll see how the Great Wall turns out, but they have a lot of U.S. talent here. It depends if this is going to be a collaboration or not. But does Disney really need to have an olive branch out to the Chinese film industry, considering how strong the brand is? Now, this is where things also get really interesting. I think that the live-action Mulan could be as big as the upcoming live-action Beauty and the Beast. However, The Little Mermaid was announced with Lin-Manuel Miranda, which I mention at every chance I can because I can't believe that nobody pays attention to that. But the line, so that didn't, that never trended. And last I checked, this Mulan story hadn't trended yet. Maybe it has now. It just broke a little bit ago. But The Lion King for Jon Favreau trended immediately. So that's a way to keep an eye on this. This is a huge problem for Sony. I think they might have to scrap their project. But I think that the biggest problem this is for is Paramount and DreamWorks' Ghost in the Shell. Because everybody's upset about Scarlett Johansson playing the major. And here Disney is going to be able to tell the story of Mulan without having to do any whitewashing. Now, I've said before, Ghost in the Shell, if they'd had a named director, they could have had an Asian actress in the lead, but it didn't go down that way. And I still feel there's a lot of good that's coming with Ghost in the Shell and the very strong, rich supporting roles that have been cast with Asian talent. So it's a tough situation. I think things could potentially have broken Ghost in the Shell's way, but this is an inconvenient hiccup for them. People are going to use this against that movie and also potentially The Great Wall as well. So I'm pretty excited. I hope this comes together well. So far, it looks very good. I'd love to see all these movies do well, and I'm curious to hear your thoughts on it as well. All right, thanks everyone, and you can check out some more videos right now.